Oh my God!
Wow. Hola amiguitos, ¿cómo estamos? Hola amigos, les habla su fiel compañero Oscar Memo. Sí, ¿cómo estás tú? Tú, cabrón. Espero que bien.
Hello friends, Shadow, Fast. I have been watching a lot of tutorials. Some of them are very long. Here is a proof that I have been like watching a lot of shadows and shadow tutorials and shadow. I have prepared you these files so you can explain you better how. Okay, we're going to open two pictures in the same program. You're going to go to here in color. You see this wheel, the colors in here. You're going to get the eyedropper and you're going to do this. Just look at this. When you do this with the eyedropper, you can see in here that the tones, that these little things, the markers, are always below the 50%. Where there's more light, this will go more to the right. You know, this goes way back to the right. So if you use the eyedropper, it will happen the same. Colors are always on the left because it's very dark. And when you go to a bright place, they will go all the way to the right. If you want to make a darker drawing, markers will always be below 50% of this. If you get this drawing, you can see in here that the tones are always below, almost always below 50%. Hue is the name of the color, luminosity is the brightness of the color, and saturation is how much of pure color is the mix. Colors get grayer, the less saturation they are. You can use Photoshop or Clip Studio Paint, it's the same thing. The thing with shadows must make the drawing look nicer. If you don't have good shadow, it's could happen to your drawing. If you see this to this, they are better tones and shadows. You can see in here that this is not like always on the top. Just look, they are below 50%. So if you want to make a drawing that has very good shadow, you have to get a picture of someone that is professional. Let's go to canvas size. Let's do this. This is a very good way to practice, a very nice way to practice. Okay, let's do this. So this is the like a finished product, okay? This is the shadows. You can start by doing the shadows, because sometimes when you start with the shadows, you can make very nice things. Just look at this drawing. Just look at these fine shadows. You only have to add shadows and you can make things go wow, like wow, this is nice. Just look, I have a lot of more examples. I have this. You have to make the line arts, then you have to look the eyedropper and just look to the left. You have to have your tones to the left, because if you start with this in the middle or in here, you will have no space to luminosity and saturation. This is some pathetic drawings I made long ago. I mean, wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. A lot of So if you put this, just look at this. The tones are oversaturated and over luminosity. They are so bright, it looks wrong. Just look at this yellow. The yellow is to the max. If you want to make this good, you get this color and you go all the way in here. Then you do this. Okay? This drawing is like when I was like, I don't know, 20 years. I don't know. This part is if you have a light, a very bright light to the face. Okay, returning to my drawing, let's say that if you start with the shadows, then you only start to paint. So let's say that you make a new layer and you get a skin brush, and you get, imagine that you don't know what tone to get, so you can get from Google and you start to do this. That's it. You see the difference. I don't recommend you to use the blending mode, because the blending modes change a lot the color. Always paint in normal. This is like the base colors. You can use a skin brush with very little amount of paint and opacity. When you finish, you duplicate the layer, go for the highlights. Always check this. This must be always below 50. That's the key. In this part, there's a lot of lights. So you can just start like doing this. When you make shadows, there's something that is reflective light in the sky, in a blue sky. So light reflects in his body. So you can see in here blue. So you get the blue and you just like this, because it's like reflecting. But these lights go, the reflecting lights go in the ends. Okay, you have to get a color from here. From you have to move slightly to the left and then you get the color. I don't know why, but this is how it works. You get this is a good reference, just copy and paste it, and just look at this shadow. It's the same thing. This picture has a lot of brightness. Oh, look, they are below. The thing in here is you must practice a lot. That's the key word in here, okay? You have to practice and practice and practice and do this and do that. Experiment, you have to always do different things. If you don't get the color you want because it's in multiply, then you must do a normal layer. You get the color from your reference and you do this. Always use normal reference if you want the same color you want to use. Watch a lot of tutorials. Only 20%. I don't recommend you to watch a lot of tutorials if you don't practice. You must practice more than you. I don't know why, but I don't like a lot to watch tutorials. I prefer just to go to draw and get a lot of experience. If you have this, you can use a blend and you just blend the colors. You zoom and then you use this brush and you do like this. You start to make these little parts. Give you more tutorials. This is my way of teaching you how to do things. You have to practice more than you see theory. You must practice, that's it. That's the key word in here. This is a get reference. Do this all day. Enjoy what are you doing. Don't get frustrated if you don't get the results you want. You will start losing and you will end winning. So just look at this. This is one of my drawings. Just look. Very bad. And now tenacity is a key to go beyond. And that's it. I hope you like it. See you around. Bye bye. Love you.
Hello guys, how you doing? I hope you like my video. I'm doing other stuff, but I have time to make you this video. It took me time, but I love and I like to give you free stuff like tutorials and tips to be a better artist. Thank you so much and see you next time. Bye.